For more on the ANC's election manifesto, I'm joined now by NEC member Lindiwe Zulu. Ms. Zulu, thank you for your time and good morning to you. I just want to reflect on, you know, the ANC's manifesto yesterday, obviously on what the president, Cyril Ramaphosa, has had to say. A lot of it, the tone of, you know, being apologetic, empathetic, of reflection, renewal, revitalization of the organization seems to have been, you know, part of the themes of the president just yesterday. But I wanted to just reflect on those failures and as well as those admissions. And as to, you know, why do you think, you know, South Africans at this point should base their votes based on, you know, the apology and not based on the right and the good that the ANC had done in the past, if any? Your reflections on the president's speech yesterday.
Thank you very much for the opportunity. And may I start by saying to you, it's a holistic approach of the presentation that was made by the president in terms of the entire manifesto as it reflects, one, what the African National Congress has been able to do, but two, what the African National Congress is preparing itself to do towards the future. And therefore, the issue of the mistakes that have been done that the African National Congress is accepting must also be taken in a broader context of the history of the ANC in government in the past 27 years, but in particular with regard to local government structures, because it is a fact, as the manifesto itself indicates and what the president indicates, is that most of the challenges or the problems that the African National Congress has had has been in the main at local government.
With that being said, it seems the ANC knows exactly what the people of South Africa want. And I want to quote the president. He said last night, the South African people want water, electricity, sanitation, refusal removal. They want faulty substations, burst pipes and overflowing drains fixed. These are just some of the things that he mentioned that he knows South Africans want. Why hasn't the ANC fixed those problems yet in our, you know, communities, in our municipalities? Why hasn't the ANC yet attended to South Africans' needs?
The president, as well as the manifesto, clearly indicates the challenges that we have faced, including the fact that even the people that sometimes we've been fielding, particularly at local government, were not people that had the capacity, and including the fact that in the selection process of the African National Congress, we did make those mistakes of selecting sometimes, because it's also, on the other hand, it must not be taken that almost everyone that was selected was not the right candidate. But it is clear that in many of the places where there's more challenges, it is where we were supposed to be more rigorous in terms of the selection. You can see, as the president was explaining, for instance, the fact that our selection process has been completely changed, has been completely overhauled, and this is because we are listening to the people. When the ANC says it has taken its candidates through the communities, which we did in the past, but not as rigorously as we did, this time around, our candidates were presented not only to the ANC, having been selected by the ANC itself, the candidates were put forward to the communities so that communities can have their say whether this candidate they are comfortable with, they know the candidate, the candidate lives within the community, they also know the capacity of the candidate. That is why our selection process really needed to be rigorous. Also, you will realize that the candidates or supposed candidates who might be mayors, where we all make it, they will have to go through an interview, which has never been the case in the African National Congress. When we do the interviews is when we are now doing your security check and all. But this time around, each candidate will have to sit in front of a panel and explain why he or she believes that she is the right person for the job. That for us as the African National Congress is now a step forward of changing our system so that they respond to the needs of our people, but also they respond to our own talk about renewing ourselves. They respond to the needs of the people,
right,
because we need people that are going to be able to deliver.
Absolutely. And I suppose the point you're making about candidates, Ms. Zulu, not only shows the flaws in candidates, at least in the past, who have been councillors, mayors in parts of, you know, South Africa that have been ripped with corruption, but also the tender processes as well. What's the ANC's plan there on not only dealing with the individuals and the candidates, but also the processes that seem to be flawed, that lead to corruption? At the verge of this, we see, you know, South Africans who fall victim because of lack of service delivery.
Yes, we have accepted as the African National Congress, and one of the reasons why we have institutions that are supposed to assist us with that, we believe we need to strengthen our institutions in such a way that it becomes very difficult for people to be corrupt in the system. When your systems don't work, then is when people take advantage of the system. It is also for this reason, by the way, from a broader context, that the African National Congress and its government has spoken about the capacity of the state. The capacity of the state, firstly, it's about the people that are working in there, from your officials to everybody. But again, it must speak to fixing the institution so that it again becomes very difficult. It is possible. I can just make a simple example, for instance, with our, as a Minister of Social Development, obviously, with regard to the 350 that we have been paying to people. We've done our best in the payment of more than 9 million people to have far less people who are accessing the system. How did we do that? We realized that we have to do our best not to have in between us people who interview people, and while interviewing people would be looking at how they can get the money. Yes, we accept the fact that some civil servants started to apply and some of them got the money and we have to close, but it's about fixing the system so that it becomes difficult for any individual at whatever level to those opportunities.
We have to leave it there. I appreciate you talking to me this morning, ANC NEC member Lindiwe Zulu. Thank you for your time.